Can a robot be too performant to be safe around humans? Today on AI News, we're taking a closer look at Figure 03 going outside for the first time ever to see its hardware in action in the real world without any marketing glitz, and it includes some unexpected results. But first, let's start with this footage of the Figure 03 running around the parking lot with the Figure team. And Brett Adcock, the CEO of Figure, has stated that the upper running speed of this robot is about 6.5 miles per hour. And something interesting to note here, as you get a close-up on these toes, you can see that they articulate, they bend at the toes, and it mimics the natural running gait of the human. You can see everything from the legs looks to be quite realistic, but once you get up to the hips, there is a little bit of stiffness. Tell me what you think down below. It seems like there could be a little bit more articulation in the waist, but overall, the gait of this robot seems to be almost impeccable. And remember, this has a garment. This, in this case, is wearing a black garment, comes in white as well as gray, but it eliminates the pinch points here to prevent debris from entering into the components. Like here, there's probably all kinds of particles in the air that could build up over time and cause substantial maintenance costs. So because of this design now, this closed design without the pinch points, hopefully it would mean that it can run longer without running into different troubles or having to replace its motors or actuators, etc. And something else to note here is that this robot is using its Helix AI system, and it's not teleoperated. And it's also using two RGBD cameras in its head, as well as six RGB cameras throughout its body, powered by its onboard NVIDIA RTX GPUs. And it would be interesting to know if, when the robot is running, if it would be using its cameras in its hands or just in its torso and head. And you tell me how much you would be willing to pay for this kind of a robot. And would you want it to be governed? Should it only be able to run at a certain rate? And in just a second, I'm going to show you another angle of this robot running. But overall, we could see that it looks like it should be close to production level. Brett Adcock was speaking last year that he intended to go into mass production in 2026. And from everything that we can see, it looks like this robot is about ready for prime time. And we do know that it's done thousands of hours, working 10 hours a day per robot at the BMW plant over the last 2 years. And this footage of the robot accelerating from standstill into a full jog is even more telling of where it is right now. It's quite impressive. Although it is running on pretty much completely flat pavement, would be important to see how it works on inclines or maybe rocks. Sand would be a good one too. And this robot weighs 61 kilograms and features a 20 kilogram payload and stands at a height of 5 feet 8 inches. And so far, the price of the robot hasn't been disclosed, although Brett Adcock hinted towards a $20,000 to $30,000 range, that of a car. But something that they didn't mention so far was a subscription model. There should be some kind of a leasing structure. At the same time, EngineAI just released its own brand new footage of the T800 robot, but so far it's only been seen doing flips and tricks instead of long horizon tasks or highly dexterous manipulations like we've seen from other robots. And because of this, it now feels more like a cool toy than a general purpose, dexterous, intelligent humanoid, but we'll see what it learns in the future. As for price, the base model T800 starts at $25,000, with the upgraded Max Edition costing over $50,000. And it does look like they've eliminated pinch points and equipped the T800 with what looks to be three-fingered hands, but it's still hard to measure this robot's level of autonomy. And on the topic of autonomy, LimX released what it calls first autonomous deployment from containers, and LimX demos swarm control here, as well as emergent collective intelligence, although it doesn't specify what that exactly is. But for now, they do have the swarm-controlled robot dancing demonstration. So the question is, what could swarms of humanoids be used for? So this swarm autonomy could be interesting in terms of having these robots using their dexterous hands at scale. For instance, this could be deployed in factories to take over unskilled labor positions or dangerous positions, which already Figure has robots in BMW's plants. But because Ollie looks to be a cheaper alternative, it could end up being something that could be deployed at scale for use cases that generally wouldn't be able to support a higher price tag humanoid. Meanwhile, generative AI also just had its own breakthrough as Anthropic released Cowork, a new tool that extends Claude's capabilities beyond conversation into direct file manipulation on a user's computer. It's currently available in research preview for Claude Max subscribers on macOS, but it's a huge leap for non-developers. The system works by granting Claude access to designated folders on the user's machine, and from there, Claude can read, edit, and create files autonomously. Practical applications include organizing cluttered directories, generating spreadsheets from screenshots of data, or even drafting documents from unstructured notes. But what distinguishes Cowork from standard conversational AI is its level of autonomy. As users assign a task, Claude independently develops and executes a plan while providing status updates throughout the process, and multiple tasks can even be queued simultaneously, allowing for parallel execution. But Anthropic has also implemented several safeguards, where Claude can only access explicitly approved folders and request permissions before taking significant actions. Despite all this, though, the company acknowledges inherent risks, including the potential for destructive actions if instructions are misinterpreted and vulnerabilities to prompt injection attacks on your computer. So tell us down below if you would trust Claude Cowork to develop on your computer and whether or not you've used it so far. Anyways, like and subscribe for more AI news, and we're going to leave you with this video of the latest from P&D Robotics and its humanoid doing maneuvers.